Good morning, students. I am Venkatramana, assistant professor of mathematics. Today I am going to explain the calculation of residues for the complex valued functions. In last class we discussed the Lorentz series expansion and the Taylor series expansion. Before we going to the residues, I will explain the Lorentz series expansion. What is meant by Lorentz series expansion? It is f of z is equal to Lorentz series expansion f of z is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity an into z minus a whole power n plus sigma n equal to n equal 0 to infinity bn by z minus a whole power n. Here f of z is nlt within the annular region between two concentric circles C1 and C2, having the center, same center, and having different radius R1 and R2, R1 greater than R2, that is any point within the annular region, then f of z is equal to sigma n equal 0 to infinity an into z minus a whole power n plus n equal 0 to infinity bn by z minus a whole power n, that is the combinations of positive and negative powers of z minus a. Then what is an here? An equal to 1 by 2 pi I. An is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z by z minus a whole power n plus 1 dz. This is the value of an. And bn is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z by z minus a whole power minus n plus 1 dz. That is the value of b. Then here the what is meant by residues. In these residues, this mode of residue depends on expansion of Lorentz series. What is the expansion of Lorentz series? F of z is equal to sigma n equal to 0 to infinity n equal to 0 to infinity an into z minus a whole power n plus sigma n equal to 0 to infinity bn by z minus a whole power n. This is the total Lorentz series expansion. In this one, the coefficient of 1 by z minus a in the Lorentz series expansion of f of z about the isolated singular point z equal to a is called the residue of f of z at that point. a0 plus a1 plus a2 so on, b1 plus b2 plus on so on. Here the coefficient of 1 by z minus a, generally it is called b1, 1 by z minus a. In the expansion of f of z about the point, isolated singular point z equal to a is called the residue of f of z at that point. So generally residue of f of z at z equal to a is residue of f of z at z is equal to a is the coefficient of 1 by z minus a. 1 by z minus a means put n equal to 1, or 1 by z minus a coefficient, that is equal to b1. That b1 is equal to 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z dz. F of z dz, that is the definition of residue. Residue of f of z, nothing but the coefficient of 1 by z minus a in the Lorentz series expansion of f of z about the isolated singular point z equal to a. Generally residue of f of z at z equal to a is b1 n equal to 1, b1 by z minus a, b1 by z minus a. So the coefficient of 1 by z minus a is b1. And we know bn value. In this one, put n equal to 1, we get b1, then 1 by 2 pi I integral over c f of z dz. That is the value of residue at z equal to a. The coefficient of 1 by z minus a in the Lorentz series expansion of f of z about the isolated singular point is called the residue of f of z at that point. That is, residue of f of z at z equal to a is b1, where b1 is 1 by 2 pi a integral over c f of j dz. That is the total definition of residue. Remember it. It's a very, very important definition for the residue. Then coming to the how to calculate the residues. Calculation of residues at the poles. Here we have two cases. First one, when z equal to a is a simple pole. Simple pole means pole of order 1. Then residue of f of z is residue of f of z and z equal to a is limit z tends to a z minus a into f of z, z minus a into f of z. When z equal to a is a simple pole of order 1 and a is singular point, this singular point is a pole of order 1, then residue of f of z at z equal to a is limit z tends to a, z minus a into f of z. Residue of f of z at z equal to a is z tends to a, z minus a into f of z. That is the residue at z equal to a where a is a pole of order 1 or simple pole. Next, when z equal to a is a pole of order m more than 1, then residue of f of z at z equal to a is residue of f of z at z is equal to a is 1 by limit z tends to a 1 by m minus 1 factorial into d power m minus 1 by dz power m minus 1 into z minus a whole power m into f of z. Here z equal to a is a pole of order m, so 1 by m minus 1 factorial into d power m minus 1 by dz power m minus 1 into z minus a whole power m into f of z. When z equal to a is a pole of order 1, then residue of f of z at z equal to a is limit z tends to a, z minus a into f of z, that is z minus a whole power 1. Next, z equal to a is a pole of order m, then residue of f of z at z equal to a is limit z tends to a, 1 by m minus 1 factorial, d power m minus 1 by dz power m minus 1 into z minus a whole power m into f of z. So try to remember these two definitions. First one is for residue at z equal to a when z equal to a is a simple pole or pole of order 1. Second one is residue of f of z at z equal to a when z equal to a is a pole of order m. Then coming to the third one, if f of z is of the form pi of z by psi of z, function of z by again function of z, pi of z by psi of z, f of z is in the form of pi of z by psi of z, whenever f of z is equal to pi of z by psi of z. Then, and suppose we wish to calculate the residue of f of z at z equal to some point z naught. At some point z naught, in that case, pi of z by psi of z naught, then residue of f of z is residue of f of z is equal to at z equal to z naught is pi of z naught by psi dash of z naught. Here pi of z naught not equal to 0 and psi dash of z naught not equal to 0, but psi of z naught is 0. Pi of z naught not equal to 0, psi of z naught equal to 0 and psi dash of z naught not equal to 0. See the difference between psi of z naught equal to 0, psi of z naught not equal to 0. Then residue at z equal to z naught is pi of z naught by psi dash of z naught. Suppose psi dash of z naught is 0, then its residue is pi of z naught by psi double dash of z naught. Psi double dash of z naught. Repeat like this. So if f of z is of the form pi of z by psi of z, where psi of z naught is 0 and pi of z naught not equal to 0, then residue at z equal to z naught is pi of z naught by psi dash of z naught. psi dash of z naught not equal to 0, phi of z naught not equal to 0, but psi of z naught equal to 0. Psi of z naught is 0, phi of z naught not equal to 0, and psi dash of z naught not equal to 0. Then residue is this one. Then coming to the problems, find the poles of the function f of z equal to z square by z minus 1 into z minus 2 whole square, and the residues at these poles is very very important problem. So it is 7 marks. What are the poles? What are the given function? F of z is equal to, first one, f of z is equal to z square by z minus 1 into z minus 2 square. That is the first step. For the poles, the poles of f of z are given by, z minus 1 into z minus 2 square equal to 0. Then z equal to 1 comma z equal to 2, these are the poles. Here z equal to 1 is a pole of order 1, z equal to 2 is a pole of order 2. Once again, f of z is z square by z minus 1 into z minus 2 whole square. The poles of f of z are given by z minus 1 into z minus 2 whole square equal to 0. Simplify, we get z equal to 1 and z equal to 2. Here z equal to 1 is a pole of order 1, z equal to 2 is a pole of order 2. Then calculate the residues at z equal to 1 and z equal to 2. For z equal to 1, here z equal to 1 is a simple pole. So residue of f of z at z equal to 1 is limit z tends to 1 z minus 1. See that z tends to 1 z minus 1, z tends to minus 1 z plus 1, z tends to a z minus e into f of z. That is the definition of the residue at z equal to a, and z equal to a is a simple pole. So limit z tends to 1 z minus 1 into, what is f of z? Z square by z minus 1 into z minus 2 square. Z minus 1 cancel, and replace every z by 1, 1 by 1 minus 2 minus 1 square 1. So what is the residue at z equal to 1? Is 1. First up, f of z, the poles of f of z are 1 and 2. Here, z equal to 1 is a simple pole, z equal to 2 is a pole of order 2. Then calculate the residue of f of z at z equal to 1. Limit z tends to 1, z minus 1 into f of z, z minus 1 into f of z, well, z square by z minus 1 into z minus 2 whole square, cancellation of z minus 1, z square by z minus 2 whole square, and replace z by 1, we get 1. Done. How to calculate the residue of f of z at z equal to 2? For this one, residue of f of z at z equal to 2 is, it is a pole of order 2. Pole of order 2 means 1 by 2 minus 1 factorial. In the formula, replace m by 2 into d power m minus 1, 2 minus 1, d by dz of, d by dz of z minus a whole square, z minus 2 whole square into f of z, and limit z tends to 2, that equal to limit z tends to 2, 1 factorial is 1, remaining value d by dz of z minus 2 square into f of z square by z minus 1 into z minus 2 square. Just z minus 2 square cancel, that equal to limit z tends to 2, remaining value z square by z minus 1 of d by dz of this value, and apply the derivative formula, limit z tends to 2 z minus 1 into z z square derivative 2z minus z square into 1 by z minus 1 all square. And replace every z by 2, 2 minus 1, 1 into this value 4 minus z square again 4 by 2 minus 1, 1, so value is 0. In this one, replace z by 2, we get 0. That is the residue of f of z at z equal to 2. Limit z tends to 2, d by dz of, this is the formula, residue of f of z when z equal to a is a pole of order m, that is 1 by m minus 1 factorial, limit z tends to a d power m minus 1 by dz power m minus 1 into z minus a whole power m into f of z. That is the total formula. In this one, replace m by 2 and simplify, we get the residue. Then coming to the next column, determine the poles and residues of the function f of z equal to cot z. What is the function f of z is equal to cot z? Cot z means cos z by sin z. For the poles, we are equating denominator to 0, sin z equal to 0. Sin z equal to 0 means z equal to sin inverse 0. Sin inverse 0 means z equal to plus or minus n pi. N is 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, plus or minus 3 and so on. These are the poles. So these are all are the simple poles. So what are the poles? Z equal to 0, plus or minus pi, plus or minus 2 pi, plus or minus 3 pi and so on. These are the poles. What is the function? Cos z by sin z. Poles are given by sin z equal to 0, this value equal to 0, then z equal to plus or minus n pi. So n equal to 0, plus pi, minus pi, plus 2 pi, minus 2 pi, like that. All are the simple poles of f of z. Then residue of f of z at z equal to n pi. Directly we can calculate the residue at n pi. We are giving different values to n, we get the different residues for the function. So residue of f of z equal to n pi is, here what is the function? Residue of f of z is, residue of f of z at z equal to n pi is, here the function is pi of z by psi of z. This is of the form pi of z by psi of z. N pi is pi of z by psi of z. Pi of z is cos z, psi of z is sin z at n pi. At n pi. Pi of n pi not equal to 0, but psi of n pi equal to 0. Here, psi of n pi, psi of z equal to 0 at z equal to n pi. At z equal to n pi, it is 0. So here, residue is pi of z by psi dash of z. Pi of z by psi dash of z. That is cos z by derivative of sin z, again cos z, at z equal to n pi, cos z cancel, so value is 1. Once again, here f of z is cot z, cos z by sin z. The poles are given by sin z equal to 0, then z equal to n pi, n equal to 0, plus or minus 1, plus or minus 2, so on. So here we have to calculate the residue for the function at z equal to specifically n pi. N pi means infinite number of values, n equal to 0, plus 1, minus 1, like that. So we have to calculate residue at z equal to n pi. Here the function is in the form of pi of z by psi of z. Pi of z is cos z, psi of z is sin z. Here pi of z at z equal to n pi not equal to 0. Psi of z at z equal to n pi is 0. What is pi of z here? Pi of z equal to cos z. Pi of z is cos z. Psi of z is equal to sin z. Here, psi of z psi of z at z equal to n pi is 0. Is 0. So psi of z value 0. Pi of z value not equal to 0. So here residue is pi of z by psi dash of z. So derivative of psi of z or derivative of sin z, cos z, cos z by cos z equal n pi is 1. That is the residue. This is the third formula. Calculation of residue using the third formula. Third formula. Previous one is first formula and second formula. Here third formula. Then coming to the next problem. Find the residue of the function another model. For the function f of z equal 1 minus e power 2z by z power 4 at the poles. It's very very important. Find the residues of the function 1 minus e power 2z by z power 4 at the poles. Here, what are the poles? For the poles, equate the denominator to 0. What is the denominator? Z power 4. So z power 4 equal to 0, then z equal to 0 is the pole. So have to expand the function about z equal to 0. That is 1 minus. What is the expansion of e power z? We know expansion of e power z. What is the expansion of e power z? 1 plus z square by 2 factorial plus z cube by 3 factorial and so on. It is infinite series. We know the expansion of e power z. So we know then expand e power 2z. 1 plus 2z by 1 factorial plus 2z whole square by 2 factorial plus 2z whole cube by 3 factorial and so on by z power. That is the expansion of f of z only in terms of z or about the point z equal to 0. This is the expansion of f of z about z equal to 0 or in terms of z minus 0. Z minus 0. Why you are expanding the function about z equal to 0? Here z equal to 0 is a singular point. How to get the singular points? We are equal denominator to 0, z power 4 equal to 0, then we get z equal to 0 is the singular point. So we are expanding the function f of z about the singular point. What is singular point? Z equal to 0. So we are expanding the function f of z in terms of z minus 0 or in terms of z or about the point z equal to 0. All are having the same meaning. Already we know the expansion of e power z, that is 1 plus z square by 2 factorial plus z cube by 3 factorial. In this one, replace every z by 2z, we get expansion of e power 2z. Then simplify here, this one, 1 cancel, then its value is 2z by z power 4, that is 2 by z cube. 2z whole square. 2z whole square means 4z square by z power 4. 4z square by z power 4 means 2 by z square. Next, 4 by 3z plus 2 by 3 plus 4 by 15 z. Here, from 2 by 3 onwards, all are positive powers. It is constant, it is z power 1, next term z square, and so after simplifying, we get only 3 negative terms. That is 1 by z cube, 1 by z square, 1 by z. We get only 3 negative terms, negative powers of z, negative powers of z. Z power minus 3, z power minus 2, z power minus 1. Remaining all are positive powers of z. So we get only 3 positive powers. Only 3 positive powers starts from z cube, z power 1 by z cube, 1 by z square, 1 by z. So we get only 3 negative powers of z means it is a pole of order 3, not for pole of order 4. Actually, z power 4 means 100% is a pole of order 4. But especially these problems, z equal to 4, z equal to 0 is a pole of order 3 after expanding the function about the singular point. So, z equal to 0 is a pole of order 3. Because 1 by z cube is the highest negative power of z minus 0. 1 by z cube is the highest negative power of z minus 0. Then, what is the residue? Residue of f of z equal to 0 is the coefficient of 1 by, what is the coefficient of 1 by z here? 4 by 3. 4 by 3. So, the coefficient of 1 by z in this expansion is nothing but the residue. So, residue of f of z equal to 0 is minus of 4 by 3. Value is minus 4 by 3. Once again, first, what is the function? 1 minus e power 2z by z power 4. Expand it using this formula. So 1 minus half 1 plus 2z by 1 factorial plus 2z whole square by 2 factorial plus 2z whole cube by 3 factorial and so on. And simplify, we get 2 by z cube plus 2 by z square plus 4 by 3z plus 2 by 3 plus 4 by 15z after dividing the whole numerator with z power 4. Then we get the only 3 negative powers of z. 1 by z cube, 1 by z square, 1 by z. So it is a pole of order 3. Pole of order 3 means only 3. Suppose we get 4 negative powers, 4 negative powers, then pole of order 4. 3 negative powers, pole of order 3. Pole of order 3. So it is a pole of order 3. Then how do you evaluate the residue? Residue generally nothing but coefficient of 1 by z in the above expansion. What is the coefficient of 1 by z? 4 by 3. 4 by 3. Then the residue of f of z at z equal to 0 is minus 4 by 3, minus of 4 by 3. Then coming to the next one, find the residue of z e power z by z minus 1 whole cube at its pole. At its pole. Here what is the pole? Pole nothing but what is f of z? Let f of z equal to z e power z by z minus 1 whole cube. For the pole, denominator equal to 0. So z minus 1 whole cube is equal to 0, then z equal to 1 is a pole of order 3, a pole of order 3. Then how to evaluate the residue? We know that f of z is a pole of order m, then residue is 1 by m minus 1 factorial, limit z tends to a, d power m minus 1 by dz power m minus 1 into z minus a whole power m into f of z. Here, a is 1, this is the value of a. M is 3, this is the value of m. A is 1, m equal to 3. So, substitute a by 1, m by 3 in above formula. And f of z by z e power z by z minus 1 whole cube. And z minus a whole power m means z minus 1 whole cube. So, residue at z equal to 1 is residue of f of z at z is equal to 1 is, use this formula, 1 by 3 minus 1 factorial, 2 factorial into limit z tends to 1, z tends to a was 1, d power m minus 1 means d square by dz square of z minus 1 whole square, z minus 1 whole cube into f of z. Z minus 1 whole cube into f of z. Replace m by 3, a by 1, a by 1 and m by 3. Then, so residue of f of z at z equal to 1 is, residue of f of z at z equal to 1 is, at z equal to 1 is, 1 by 2 factorial, limit z tends to 1, d square by dz square of z minus 1 whole square into z e power z by f of z, z minus 1 whole cube. This is also whole cube. Whole cube cancel. Remaining value z e power z. 2 times derivative of z e power z. So 1 by 2 factorial means 2. Limit z tends to 1. First time d by dz of z into e power z plus e power z. Then again applying derivative, 1 by 2 into limit z tends to 1, z e power z plus e power z plus e power z. Applying UV rule between z e power z and separately e power z, that equal 1 by 2 into limit z tends to 1, it is z plus 2 into e power z, and replace z by 1, it is 1 by 2 into 3 e, so answer is 3 e by 2 when z is equal to 1 and z equal to 1. Next, so determine the poles and residues of the function z square by z plus 2 into z minus 1 whole square. So here the poles are given by poles are given by z plus 2 into z minus 1 square equal to 0 implies z equal to minus 2, 0, 1. These are the poles. Here, Z equal to 0, minus 2, R. Simple poles. Z equal to 1 is a pole of order 2. That is a part 1. Next, part 2, residue. At Z equal to residue of f of z at Z equal to 0 is limit z tends to 0 z minus 0 into f of z. That is limit z tends to 0 z into f of z square by z plus 2 into z minus 1 whole square. Here z z cancel, so value is 0. Then residue of f of z at z equal to 2 is minus 2 is limit z tends to minus 2 z plus 2 into f of z. What is f of z? Z square by z plus 2 into z minus 1 whole square. Z plus 2 cancel. Z tends to minus 2 means 4 by minus 2 into minus 2 minus 1 minus 3 square is 9 plus 9. So answer is 2 by minus 2 by 9. Minus 2 by 9. Then last one. Residue at Z equal to 1. Residue at Z equal to 1. Residue, but Z equal to 1 is a pole of order. Residue of f of z at Z equal to 1 is a pole of order 2. Pole of order 2 means limit z tends to 1, 1 by 2 minus 1 factorial d by dz of z minus 1 whole square into f of z. That equal to limit z tends to 1 d by dz of z minus 1 whole square into z square by z plus 2 into z minus 1 whole square. Z minus 1 whole square cancel. That is limit z tends to 1. Applying u, that is limit d by dz of z square by z square plus 2z. That is limit z tends to 1 z square plus 2z into derivative of z square 2z minus z square into 2z plus 2 by the differentiation of u by v formula, that is z square plus 2z whole square, and replace every z by 1, that equal to 1 plus 2 3 into 2 minus 1 into 4 by 1 plus 2 whole square, 6 minus 4, 2 by 9. That is the residue at Z equal to 1, where Z equal to 1 is a pole of order. So today we are discussing the poles and residues at the poles. Poles and residues at the poles. We have two number of poles. One is pole of order 1 and second one is pole of order m. Then calculation of residues at the pole of order 1 or at the simple pole, and calculation of residue at the pole of order m, and related problems. Thank you. Sir.